Optical fibers are flexible, hair-thin transparent fiber used for propagation of light. It consists of central cylinder called as core, surrounded by cladding. Cladding is in turn surrounded by jacket. The diameter of core varies from 5 to 100 micrometer. Diameter of cladding is 125 micrometer and jacket adds another 100 micrometer to the diameter of fiber. Core is denser than that of cladding. Optical fibers are used for propagation of light by using principle of total internal reflection. We know that when light is incident from denser medium to rarer medium with angle of incidence greater than critical angle, the light gets totally reflected in the same medium without any refraction. Optical fiber works on multiple total internal reflection at core cladding interface. This way. There are two types of rays. The rays that propagate along the axis, known as axial rays. The rays that take zigzag path, known as zigzag rays. As the angle of incidence at aperture increases, angle of incidence at core cladding interface decreases. So the maximum angle that a ray can have at aperture of an optical fiber is known as acceptance angle. All the rays within this acceptance angle are accepted by the optical fiber. If the angle of incidence is greater than this acceptance angle, total internal reflection does not take place at core cladding interface. This acceptance of light by the optical fiber is given numerically by numerical aperture. It is the sign of acceptance angle and it represents light gathering capacity of an optical fiber. The formula for numerical aperture is given as sine of theta 0. It is equal to square root of n1 square minus n2 square. n1 is the refractive index of core, n2 refractive index of cladding. It is also given by n1 into root 2 delta. Delta is the fractional index difference and it is given by n1 minus n2 by n1. So numerical aperture is nothing but the measure of acceptance cone. Acceptance cone is the cone having full angle 2 theta 0 and all the rays within this cone are accepted by the optical fiber for propagation. These optical fibers are used in various fields for communication systems. We know that optical fibers used as a waveguide to transmit the signals from transmitter to receiver, typically telecommunication systems. Optical fibers are used as sensors. There are two types of sensors, active sensors and passive sensors. In active sensors, optical fibers changes their intrinsic relative core cladding difference and modifies the output. Optical fibers used as temperature, pressure and strain sensor by changing their intrinsic properties. Optical fiber can also be used as a transmitter and receiver to sense air pollution, smoke and liquid level. Here, optical fibers are just as a waveguide. Optical fibers are used in military for communication systems and fiber-guided missiles. Optical fibers are used to operate these missiles, used to send and receive signals from the missiles. It is used in entertainment, cables for satellite channels, magnifiers in television sets. It is used in medical field generally to guide the laser. So wherever lasers are used, optical fibers are applicable. The typical application of optical fiber in medical field is endoscope. Endoscope is used to see the internal organs of human body. It is an illuminated optical, typically slender and tubular instrument to see the internal organs of human body. A bunch of optical fibers with two coaxial channels used for the endoscope. The central channel is used to incident the light, and the surrounding channel is to collect the light from the internal organ. You can see here there should be a source of light and there should be a detector to detect the reflected light, and from the amplitude distribution images formed. Thank you.